Hey guys, welcome back to Avlog TV. If you're new here, welcome, welcome, welcome. You are definitely at the right place. To all my old and new subscribers, thank you for always coming back to watch my video. And if you have been watching me and you are not subscribed, please kindly hit that red subscription button and subscribe and join the family. And don't forget to turn on the notification bell so that whenever I post a new video, you will be the first person to see it, okay? So kindly subscribe and join the family, okay? So guys, in today's video, there's this video I saw online. I'm going to react to it. Video and pictures. Okay, let me start with the picture. So guys, there is this picture and video I saw online, and today I'm going to react to the pictures and the video. Definitely, I'm going to leave it on the screen for you guys to see. The first one was how a young girl died from severe pain. Died for her, this Kiko. Just look at that's the picture on the screen. The girl just passed on due to severe pain. Even me as an adult, there are some, me, in as much as I love braiding, there are some hairstyles that I cannot do due to the pain because me, I have zero tolerance for pain. So imagine doing that kind of hairstyle for a child. And according to the report, the child was even crying that she's having headache all throughout the process. She was crying that the hair is paining her, but her mom chose to ignore it. Just take a good look at the picture and look at how painful that hairstyle is. Even as an adult, if you make such hairstyle, I know generally you're going to take some drugs like paracetamol to ease the pain. So I can't imagine making such hairstyle for a child. In fact, I don't know what parents are doing now in the name of parenting or in the name of, oh, you want your baby to look beautiful. See, all these children without those heavy hairs, that they look beautiful already. Just take a good look at this beautiful baby just died because of one careless mistake from the mother, all in the name of fashion. You want your child to make one particular hairstyle. See, they are beautiful hairstyles for children that you make for them and they will look so beautiful. You don't have to make your child pass through that pain only in the name of fashion. Just take a good look at that picture. Now, how painful that hairstyle is. The girl was even complaining she's having headache. If it is, oh God, definitely I can't even do such hairstyle to my child because that's wickedness. That hairstyle is so painful. As an adult, if you make that kind of hairstyle, in fact, tonight, you won't even sleep well because of the pain. The girl was complaining of headache and the pain, but she just chose to buy paracetamol or something just to eat. But it does not work out. Their brain is still tender. Even me as an adult, this, in as much as I like braiding, there are some hairstyle I will never do due to the pain because I have zero tolerance for pain. Even this one that I just made now, I know how painful it was when I just made the hair. So I don't know what we are doing on in the name of fashion. I don't know where we are getting our fashion idea this day from. Okay, there's this other video that I'm placing on the screen for you guys. These children, they were two siblings. They made a very long hairstyle, as you can see from the screen. Even the hair was as long to their own bumper. What kind of fashion is that? What kind of fashion? Yes, hairstyle you make for children, and these children would look beautiful. These days, mothers, our parents don't even want their children to look like children anymore because this day, what you see on the internet, you see children carrying a heavy style, long braid, all sorts of hairstyle that is not even good. At the end of the day, tomorrow night, you'll be dragging us. Now, one, they don't do that. You'll be dragging us on social media. Rape or this or this, all kind of things. All because you do not want your children to look like kids. Their hairstyles you make for these kids and they will look absolutely beautiful. How can a mother bred her child of 5 years from the start? I can't even tell you, even if whether 5 or the small one should at least should be like 4 years or 5 years or so. I don't can't even place the age right now. But that hair from
from just the head to the bone, but the hairstyle was just rubbing the floor. What kind of hairstyle is that? What kind of fashion is that? Is that even fashion? Where do we get this idea from? So where do we get that kind of idea from? That's so devilish. So please, and the other one was like a month, or 1 month, 2 months, to 3 months, 0 to 3 months, like that. The mother wore her this heavy wig, as you can see from the screen. All this hairband. I can remember the first time I wore such wig. I know the pains that come with that hairband at the front. So how can you place a little child on such pain in the name of fashion? In fact, that's bad parenting. At the end of the day, now you'll be dragging, oh, justice for this, justice for this. Because this is the way we expose our children, all in the name of fashion, or in the, I don't know. In fact, parents, we need to. In my mind, I'm even wondering, where are the fathers then? Because as a responsible father, you cannot see any woman do this thing to your child and you will be happy. I don't know where we are getting this idea, this fashion from. You don't want your children to look like you. There are some things you do for children. Allow them to grow to a certain stage. Even these days, the other day I was coming to work, I saw a child of 5 years. Her mom, I think it was a birthday shoot, something like that. The mother took her to a makeup artist and they were carving her bro. In my mind, I'm just wondering, what's happening? Even without this heavy makeup on the child still look beautiful. And at the end of the day now, you take her to a makeup artist, heavy makeup. This day, you see children of 5 years, 7 years, 10 years, very long lashes, all in the name of beauty or birthday shoot or whatsoever. I don't know, we really need to caution ourselves because it's not done. Now you are, the way you are exposing these children, at the end of the day now, when they got shaped, you'll be dragging people on social media. Oh, justice for my child, this and all manner of things. Let these children grow to a state that they can even do this thing themselves. Don't expose them. Some children are way too young for the exposure they are getting now. How can you take a 5-year-old child to a makeup artist, all in the name of birthday shoot or something? At the end of the day, you give the child a heavy makeup just to look beautiful. Children don't even need all sorts of makeup before they look beautiful. They are naturally beautiful. Even their hairstyles you do for children, and they will look very perfect. You don't have to include a very long, like the other one that you just saw on the screen, that very long braid that was flowing on the. What kind of thing is that? So more that we should know what we do to our children. But all I see is just wickedness. That's not fashion. You cannot let your child go through such pain all in the name of fashion. You do all kind of hairstyle for your children. Since yesterday, when I've been training all this, I don't want to even go into that because the way parents expose their children is alarming now. The Bible says we should train our child in the way they should grow up, and when they grow old, they will not depart from it. Parents, my advice to parents, let these children be children. Let them enjoy their childhood. Let them enjoy their natural hair. Let them enjoy those 3 buns that they will just use to part their hair and they will still look beautiful. Let them enjoy their childhood. Stop exposing them to all kinds of things. Stop exposing them to growing up then, who brought you to even rub lipstick? Is it lipstick? Wet lips to even school. Where will you get lipstick from? Or the wet lip from? Even during a matter, maybe the worst we can do is use Vaseline to rub our lips. Just because of those amateur dryness and crack on the lips. But these days, though, you see a young girl, a small girl going to school with a heavy powder, brown powder, back then, which one is brown powder? Say? Back then, the highest you can rub is white powder. But these days, due to easy exposure civilization, I don't know how to place it, you see young children exposed to all kinds of things. Makeup, growing up, back then, even 15 years, where you won't even see eyebrow rub, not to talk of makeup or something. So guys, my advice to mothers and every parent out there, please let these children be children. Stop exposing them to all kinds of things. Let them grow to that state that they can do all those things. Stop exposing them. I know they are your children, but tomorrow, now don't come and drag us on social media. A child of that will be making such long break. Even me as an adult, I can't even do because it's not comfortable for me. So guys, if you have watched up to this point and you have not subscribed, kindly hit that subscription button and subscribe. And don't forget to like, share, and comment. Let me see your thoughts in the comment section. So guys, this will bring me to the end of this video. See you in my next one. Bye!